Hi, I'm Keean Johnson.
And this is Jorge Lendeborg Jr. Thanks for watching Hollywire.
What's up, Hollywire? Hanging out with Keean Johnson and Jorge Lendeborg. Hey, guys.
How's it going?
Hey, how you doing?
Good. How are you guys doing?
Pretty good.
We all showed up a little late today. Feeling good, though?
You know, yeah, it happens.
Regular LA traffic, right? Yeah.
It's not our fault. It's just LA traffic.
Totally not LA's fault. Yeah. All right, we're gonna play Hollywords with Keean and Jorge. Go ahead, whoever wants to spin first.
If I get like celeb crush, I'm gonna die laughing.
So close.
Don't you hate when it just goes back like that?
This wheel, it knows it's what rigged. You don't want to talk about.
Dude, I'm Amy Adams.
She's actually here right now. Should we grab her? I'm just kidding.
Okay.
Who would you like to work with? Let's cast you in a rom-com.
Oh, okay. So it's like, who do I want? So you're saying, who's my celebrity crush? I mean, I don't know if she would do a rom-com with me, but Helena Bonham Carter would be a great choice. It'd be a weird love story.
It would be super weird, but she's fantastic.
Or maybe any other thing, you know.
Yeah. She's fantastic, okay. Alita, Battle Angel. Tell me a little bit about your characters, because it's a pretty crazy movie.
Yeah, I mean, I think the best way to start explaining it is we're all living in this place called Iron City.
Right.
And above Iron City is this beautiful sky city called Zalem. And I play Hugo. Hugo lives in Iron City. He's an orphan, has been there his whole life, and our characters just kind of learn to fend for ourselves. And you know, when Alita comes into this world of Iron City, everything kind of changes.
Yeah, I mean, alongside Hugo's character, you know, his best friend and partner in crime is Tanji. You know, like you said, we fend for ourselves in this town, and Alita kind of comes through and makes everybody really look at themselves and just kind of pushes them to the next stage in their life.
And Iron City is pretty much a real city, right? It was completely built mm-hmm. out.
Living, breathing, smoke coming out of weird places and everything. Yeah, it was cool. Robert and the whole team, they came in and they built like blocks and blocks of Iron City. You know, it was up, I believe, like three stories high. There was a bunch of cargo. It was everything. It felt like when we were filming in the lot, it felt like we were really in this really huge practical set. Like really felt the scope of everything. Mm.
Mm-hmm. And what was it like watching the movie back, because Rosa doesn't really look like herself? It's completely different.
Yeah, I mean, you see the photos on the computer when Robert was showing like what she might look like, but you know, not until it's actually moving and it looks photoreal until you know it. Yeah, that's the most mind-blowing part. Especially all like the intimate moments and stuff like that of wherever like touching or even the kiss, like those things are, you know, so intimate. So to be doing that and kind of, you know, it's like I was saying the other day, I kind of felt catfished a little bit.
I mean, you guys are fantastic, but what is it like working with this cast? Did you ever get starstruck?
Yeah, I think it was just, it started to get a little nerve-wracking like once I did get the part, and then, you know, it was like, you know, Variety says that Christoph Waltz is signing on to, you know, the show. And I'm like, oh God. And then Mahershala Ali is signing on, Jennifer Connelly. I'm like, oh, this is a really big movie. So I think it was, you know, a little nerve-wracking then. But obviously when you meet the people, you know, they make you feel so comfortable. And you're like, you just realize they're just, you know, he's just a regular guy with two Oscars.
Mm-hmm. Oscars.
They hit up the crafty station just like everyone else.
Yeah, 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 just chilling. And he had just such a nice, sweet disposition. I wasn't as scared of him as I thought I was going to be.
Did you guys get to do any stunts?
A little bit.
Rollerblading?
Yeah, we got to do some rollerblading. There's this whole kind of chase with me and Ed Skrein's character, and I was able to do a few of the stunts there, all within reason. You know, they want to be very careful.
But of course, yeah.
You know, it was cool that they were able to, you know, allow me to do a few different parkour runs. Set, you know, not any jumping off bridges or anything like that, but as much as I was able to do.
Yeah, yeah. I mean, would you have jumped off the bridge?
Yeah, you know, I would. I definitely would.
I give that a hard no for me.
Man, that's a no for me, dog.
Yeah.
I was
trying to impress the other skaters at one point, and there was a ramp, and I was sitting, and they were like telling me, they're just like, all you have to do is stand. I was like, I should not be trying to do a ramp on like my third day of skating.
No.
I was like, you know what? I gotta prove to these guys that, you know, I can skate too. And I came down and landed right on my arm and felt like I almost broke it. So I didn't do that anymore.
That's insane. And then me and George would be in the back eating our pineapple pizza, being like, nuh-uh. Mm-hmm.
Laughing.
Yeah, told you so.
Not me, though.
Told you so. All right, thanks for watching, and be sure to watch Alita Battle Angel.